Siobhan McCready, United Union. Currently an example of a good Scottish diet. Corporate, I'm part of a fostering family. Over the last 25 years, we've supported a lot of children and young people. And it's a role like no other. It's not a job, it's a completely different role. I'm incredibly proud of the young woman with me this weekend. She's a spokesperson for young people in care, a veteran of 5 Labour conferences. She's a passionate, determined young woman, and she reminds us daily of why we do this. However, for too many of our children and young people in care, therapeutic support is simply not there. If it is, it is fragmented, short-term at best. Research shows that 50% of mental health issues are established by the age of 14, 75% by the age of 24. Not unsurprisingly, young people in care are disproportionately represented in these groups, as are those from those lowest incomes, the areas of deprivation, all the target groups that we know all too well about. Support from child and adolescent mental health services has waiting times, delays in diagnosis, and somewhat of a postcode lottery at the moment. It's simply not good enough. Children and young people in our care need much more than just a cuddle and a nice home. That's the least we can offer them. They need nurturing, therapeutic inputs, and above all, sustained and joined up support throughout the lifetime of their care. Foster carers' roles are to be advocates for our young people, however, there is increasingly frustration around CAM support. Children need to be in stable placements to get therapeutic care, but lack of planned support puts their stability at risk. We are letting our young people down as a result. As an educator, I know you cannot learn unless you're in a place to do so. Without mental well-being, a child or a young person is simply not in that place. How can they be? What we need is a fresh approach, investment in therapeutic support throughout the young person's time in care, joined up services responsive to their needs. Without it, attainment will remain a challenge and the cycle of care remains in place. Nothing changes. This is a plea to listen to young people in care and their carers too. We are the experts in this. Young people need so much more than just what's currently being provided. They are our future and they deserve so much of our support. Let's do the right thing and provide the support they need to lead healthy lives. Break the cycle, fund decent services and support the motion. Thank you.